All right, so when you guys think of Black history, think of the Black people who have contributed to America. Who are the individuals that you initially think about?
George Washington Carver.
All right, George Washington Carver.
Jackie Robinson.
Barack Obama.
Frederick Douglass.
Rosa Parks.
Martin Luther King Jr.
Harriet Tubman.
Malcolm X.
Michelle Obama.
Thurgood Marshall.
Lonnie Johnson. All right. So, we got a nice list of people that we already know about, right? You guys have heard about them before. You probably did some report about them at some point in elementary school. But let's focus on some individuals that are not well known, right? Because there's plenty of people who've made contributions to America.
Right.
So y'all ready to get started?
Yeah.
All right, let's get started. Shut your mouth. I'm only talking about Shaft. Shaft was a hit movie in 1971, depicting a Black private detective taking down some mobsters to save a girl while being super cool. This film started the genre of blaxploitation, a genre where Blacks were heroes in their films instead of villains. Gordon Parks, the first African-American director in Hollywood, led the charge on this genre, which other directors like Spike Lee and Quentin Tarantino used as inspiration for some of their Academy Award winning films. Prior to Hollywood, Parks was a freelance photographer for Vogue and Life magazine, taking pictures of working class people and highlighting their economic conditions. This type of photography and art was known as social realism. He took pictures of Muhammad Ali, Malcolm X, Stokely Carmichael, who was a member of the Black Panthers, and many others. He also penned 15 novels and was the co-founder of Essence Magazine. That is a lot for a guy who didn't finish high school.
Have you ever heard of the Harlem Renaissance? A glorious time in history where Black art was celebrated by all. Music, paintings, literature, we excelled. Who started this movement? A Harvard graduate Rhodes Scholar named Alan Leroy Locke. See, this Black man, after studying philosophy abroad, decided to come back and encourage other Black people to start talking and depicting African American subjects. He then dropped his collection of work, The New Negro, which highlighted some of the writers you know like Langston Hughes and Zora Neale Hurston. He put us on the map.
How did Black History Month start? Thank Carter G. Woodson. Woodson is the father of Black History Week term month. In 1926, Woodson selected February as the month to celebrate a week of African American history in honor of Frederick Douglass, one of the greatest auteurs and abolitionists in American history, and Abraham Lincoln, the president who helped free the slaves. A graduate of Harvard University, Woodson dedicated himself to studying African American history. As he learned more and more, he established and published his findings in scholarly journals and books. The Miseducated of the Negro became a part of the literary canon for many colleges and universities. Thank you, Mr. Woodson.
As you can see, we have a bunch of people that made contributions to our society. Many that don't get the recognition that they should get. Let's make sure that we start giving these individuals the more recognition, start researching them more, and start talking about these individuals more.